Welcome back to my channel. I'm back again with another video. It's me, your girl Dream. If you're not yet, I'm gonna need you to subscribe and yeah, stop what you're doing and turn on your post notifications just to be aware of every time I post. Today we're gonna be doing something different. We're gonna be doing a mukbang with Five Guys, but Five Guys still hasn't gotten here yet, so we're just waiting on them. It has like 15 more minutes. If not, it said 15 minutes, like 15 minutes. Actually just called, but we're about to be smoking a little bit because it's probably already cold because she took a minute to get here, so I don't want to waste my time and smoke and then it's gonna get even colder. But we are about to smoke a little bit before we I'm already high. I just smoked on live with you guys. Yeah, and everybody was saying mukbang. Asked y'all what should I get to eat, so I'm like, you know what, let me do a mukbang because I don't do these. So yeah, let's park up. Also, if y'all couldn't tell, I have no makeup on, so don't judge me.
I can't, no contacts, no.
So I finally got here. So as some of you guys may know, the other day I was on live. I've been getting on live a lot lately, but I was telling y'all a story, right? But the funny part about it is that y'all didn't even get to hear the story because I accidentally muted myself and I didn't see none of the comments with you guys saying, oh my gosh, Dream, we can't hear. Like, y'all were hilarious with it, dude. So you already know the business. If you're smoking with me, let me know what you're smoking in the comments below. Like I said before, your girl never knows what she's smoking.
Feel like Tupac, call me Machiavelli. It really ain't shit, a bro didn't get to me. I'm walking around with a chop in the hip, pop the little bass. For a nigga, go ahead, suck it through the drawers for a nigga. And take my body case if I get it. Walk hard with the activist, I'm sipping. I still got Molly in my system. I still got Zannies on me.
So yeah, now I'm basically just about to be telling y'all the same story that nobody heard but myself. I was so blown, like, I really wanted to pull my hair out my scalp. But whatever, we're about to be telling the same story today. So if you want to listen to that and watch me smoke and watch me eat, then stay for that. First, let me take a bite because, bitch, I'm craving this. This shit took forever. This shit took 42 minutes to get here. I ordered it with extra cheese. If you know me, you know I love cheese. Cheese is my thing. It's always my thing. Like, it will forever be my thing. But they drenched it in mayo. I hate that. Ooh. And it's hot too. Wraps. All that literally just hit the spot. So now I feel like we can start with the story. Okay, we're not done eating or smoking yet, but I'm just gonna start with the story. I was basically talking about on my live that when I was in Spain, I was just a badass child, and like that's why my mom decided to send me here to America, blah blah blah.
Wow, look at that pimple.
I shouldn't have touched it. Don't touch your pimples, kids, because and I hope it doesn't spread. I'm gonna be pissed because I worked so hard. I know it's not the best skin yet, but it was worse, best believe. I got pictures from before and after. Y'all gonna see the difference. Yeah, so I was a badass child in Spain. Like, so my mom decided to send me here because I was just doing all types of crazy shit. And within one of those crazy shit things that I had going on or whatever, it was me and two of my best friends in Spain. So we basically clean faked our grades the whole year until we got caught, obviously, later on. But We would go to like this place where you like pay to get on the internet and get on a computer because we didn't really have like internet and computer and stuff like that. We used to always walk to that place, me and my two best friends, and pay to get on there. So we basically went online. I'm saying this story, it's not something I'm proud of, but I'm just, you know, it's a story to tell. So either we went into like Word or like the one where you make the, we made our own little template thing, like our own little square thing where it said like math, English, PE, like each and every single subject, right? And so what we would do is right by, we would like write our grades down. We made ourselves fail like one class or two because our moms would know that we did not pass all of them because ain't no way. Just because we were those type of kids, like, you know, we were always like, yeah, we wanna be outside and, you know, I was young me, okay? I just enjoyed my time with my friends. Like, they were my bitches. So I was like, I don't know, I just want to spend all my time with them and do all these things with them. So, but yeah, we failed all those classes because we never went to school. Like, we literally skipped school. Mind y'all, we were 14 years old. So, but remember I told y'all over there, when you're 14 years old, you're really like 16, 15, 16. You're not really in the mentality set of a 14 year old. This thing is just calling me out. We did this. One of my biggest pet peeves, I hate hearing myself chew. Like, my mom would smack the fuck out of my sister every time she would be at the table, and she would just obnoxiously, like, just with her mouth open, like, everywhere at the table while everyone's eating. That shit used to be the funniest thing. Like, we all used to laugh. That was cheese. Now we compliment it with some cookies. I miss my long nails, y'all. Okay, so the business. It was like the last day of school. You know, they gave us our report card. Christmas break, right? If we brought our actual grades, that was literally our ass. Like, we were not presenting ourselves inside those houses with all those absences and all those, no, no. So that's what we had to do about it. And well, that's what we felt like we had to do about it, so that's what we did. So we went to one of my friend's moms first because my mom was last because my mom was the, like, the worst. Like, no. I was like, if she catches me, like, I might as well just kill myself because I'm not gonna let her do it. I'm just gonna do it myself. Don't take it literal because y'all know y'all be taking stuff to heart, okay? We went to one of my friend's mom's house. And then, you know, she was cool, she passed, she looked at it, she was like, all right, cool. Then we went to the next friend's house. Then her mom was definitely fine with it. She was like, okay. But actually her sister questioned it because she was a graduate from that school. And she said that, like, it looked different from, like, the report card itself looked different. And okay, what the report card was literally a sheet of paper, like, picture a white sheet of paper, right? But with, like, the school logo in the background and then the little square thing on top of it. And then it had like the little English, math, science, PE, blah, 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 and your grades and shit. And like the absences, and how many absences you had like the whole semester and stuff. So I remember I said with the school logo, like behind the little thing, what we did was just a sheet of paper with a freaking, and then at the bottom it'll have like the cutting symbols. Y'all know what I'm talking about when it has like the cutting symbol thing, and then it'll be like for the signature for the parent for you to turn that back in. You're not gonna turn in the whole sheet of paper, you're gonna cut the bottom piece and then turn that small sheet of paper just to make sure that, oh, my parents saw my grades, so it's like signed. So what we did was cut that sheet of paper and staple it to the other piece of paper. Know what I mean? To like the bigger piece of paper that we had there with the little square things. Basically our grades, our fake grades. No, so that was weird. You know, her sister was younger, kind of like us. She had just graduated maybe like 2 years before. She was kind of like with us. But she ended up, for some reason, saying, okay, blah, 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 signed it, cool. Then we went to my mom's house. My mom asked me the same thing that the sister asked. I was so freaking scared. I didn't know what to say. I'm like, this is just how it is. This is just, I mean, you could call the school. My bold ass, you could call the school. For some reason, she always did test me. She always was one of those moms when she's like, yeah, best believe I'm gonna call. Like, she's not just gonna be like, no, I believe you. Don't think that just because you said that I'm not gonna. So she said what she said and she signed it. She was fine. I was able to go out the whole Christmas. I was able, and anytime she tried to tell me, like, oh no, you can't go outside, you can't go hang out with your friends, you can't go, because that was like my thing back then. Like, I was hanging out with my friends. I was out. And whenever my mom would try to tell me, like, no, you can't go outside, you can't hang out with my friends, you can't hang out with your friends, or anything like that, I will always pull that card out. Always pull that card out and be like, oh, well, I have good grades. Like, I didn't just do that for nothing. I can't even go outside, blah, blah, blah. Like, that's how I would act on top of everything. And so there she'll just be like, all right, well, I mean, I guess she's right. She did get good grades, so you can go outside, blah, blah, blah. And y'all wanna know how I got caught? Because my homeroom teacher was my music teacher. And so I was forgetting my flute every single day. I didn't give a damn about no flute. I didn't care about no music class. I was one of those kids. Everything literally switched around when I came here though. Cause my mom knew I wasn't gonna play with my dad. And I didn't. Get me straight. I graduated high school. If I would have stayed in Spain, I wouldn't have graduated high school. So I'm thankful for that. But continuing with the story. So him as my music teacher, not as my tutor or anything, but as my music teacher, he called my mom and said, you know, like, I want to schedule a meeting. Like, Naomi's been forgetting her flute too much. And then for some reason, okay, my mom goes in, you know, I'm terrified the whole time. I'm thinking, I'm trying to remain positive and say, okay, you know, he's just gonna say that my flutes just haven't been in the music class and that I've just been forgetting it and haven't been doing what I'm supposed to in my music class. I'm trying to remain positive and not think that he's gonna be my homeroom teacher too at the meeting and freaking tell my mom that I was absent like most of the year and that my grades were really this, this, and that. All F's, really. I'm not even gonna lie, they were all. I failed everything, like literally, everything. When I was doing it, I was just like, I wasn't thinking I was being bad. I was just like, I don't know what I was thinking, honestly. I was just young, to be honest. Man, I remember they knocking. I remember somebody knocking on the door while I was in class, sitting there, just terrified. And I'm like, thinking, I don't want what's about to happen to happen. Somebody knocked on the door. My worst, like, literally, I was thinking. I was like, please don't happen. Please don't happen. Somebody knocked on the door and said my first and last name and to be excused, to pick up all my things and to be excused from the whole classroom. Instantly, you know, I start tearing up. My face is red. I'm like picking up my things. I'm like putting on my backpack. I'm like, fuck. Like, I'm thinking like the whole world's going down. Like, I'm done. I'm dead. I'm like, I'm embarrassed. I know she's disappointed. She's gonna knock the fuck out of me. And she's gonna kill me. Because my mom will always say, like, you do something else, like, I'm gonna send you with your dad, you do something else. But I will always take that for granted. Like, I'll be like, she's not gonna really send me with my dad. Like, come on. I'm like, my life is here. Like, really, come on. Like, that's how I was thinking. So, man, like, as expected, I walked into the office and she got a sheet of paper that he had just printed out and she shows me and I look at it and it's like a piece of paper with some grades on it. And she asks me, what is this? And I'm like, I don't know. Those are not, I don't know. Like, he didn't give me those grades. He gave me the grades that I gave you. I don't know what this is. And as I said that, my mom literally back slapped me like that. Like, my whole face went like this. And I kid you not, she literally slapped me in the office with my homeroom teacher, tutor, music teacher, whatever you want to call him. And I just instantly just continued crying. See, before I was teared up, now I'm crying at this point. I'm like, I don't even know. And she's just telling me to shut the fuck up in the office. Like, shut the fuck up. Like, I didn't want to hear nothing else. So I did, you know, I shut the fuck up. We didn't have a car, so the whole way home, we had to walk. And she had, like, the stroller with my brothers and stuff. And I remember her calling like my grandma and like my aunt and stuff, like for them to come because it was about to go down. And you know, I was crying the whole way home. And I'm like, I don't even know what to do right now. Like, I don't know. And I remember my grandma coming there that night. Before we got home, my grandma was already there. She caught the bus. Yeah, I guess I was a pretty rebellious child. All right, I guess. Yeah. My grandma stayed and like, she called my mom down and stuff like that. And she called me down and my mom saw she was sending me with my dad. And so after that summer, that August, she sent me with my dad. And to be honest, I didn't really have to catch the plane because I was flying by myself, which I almost didn't catch the plane. I was like, fuck it. I never said I wanted to do this. They just wasted money. I never said I wanted to get on a plane, so I'm not getting on a plane. While I was like at the boarding thing, and then something, literally something, I don't know why I got on a plane. It was just meant, like, it was just meant, I guess. I always say that I don't regret anything because everything happens how it's supposed to happen. And I'm always going to say that. And I'm always standing for that. Also, comment a food emoji if you're a cheese lover. So that's gonna conclude today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If y'all did, just make sure y'all give it a big thumbs up. Please comment if you're a big cheese lover like me. If you do, then our bond is just gonna get stronger and stronger from there because cheese, listen. Yeah, and turn on your post notifications to be notified of every single time I post. And thank y'all so much for continuing to support me.